Okay, today we are going to discuss about the growth curves of the population. So first of all, we have to consider about the typical growth curve. The typical growth curve consists of four phases. The first phase is the slow growth phase, also we call it as the lag phase, and then the second phase, which is called high growth phase, and which is also called as the exponential phase, and then the third phase, which is decelerating phase, and the fourth phase, stationary phase. So when we are considering about the slow growth phase, actually in this phase, the number of reproductively capable individuals are very less, as well as the organisms are not well adapted to their environment. Therefore, the ability to extract the resources from the environment is very less. Therefore, it shows less reproductive rate. Because of that reason, the population growth rate also in very low level. But when it reached to the second phase, which is called exponential growth phase, what happened? There is sufficient number of reproductively capable, the matured individuals, as well as they are well adapted to their environment. Now they can extract more food, more water from the environment. By that, they can maintain high reproductive rate and high growth rate. But when it reached to the decelerating phase, what happened? Now the population number has increased up to a certain level, which is very high. Because of that reason, there is always competition for the resources. We know that even the population number goes high, or the population size goes high, the resource availability may not increase. Therefore, for the resources, for the water, sunlight, and many things, there will be a competition. Rather than that, even the population number goes high, the area or the places or the locations that they are utilized for their daily life will not be increased. Because of that reason, what happened? Large number of individuals are living in a minute area. Therefore, they are all the excretory matter and the waste and many things produced by themselves accumulate in that particular environment. Therefore, the chance to spread the disease or to have the epidemic conditions will be very high. So rather than that, when there is large number of organisms living in a very minute area, even the activity of the parasites also get increased, because parasites can transmit from one to the another individuals in a very small time fragment. The parasitic activity also very high. Then, if we are going to consider further, if the population number is high, they are more visible to their predators. So we can consider that when the prey number is increasing, the predator number also increasing with that. Then the predatory activity also increase in the exponential phase. Therefore, because of the disease spread, the parasitic activities and the predation and the competition for the resources in the decelerating phase, the population growth will be reduced. Then we are moving to the stationary phase. In the stationary phase, what happened? The environment and the population come to a conclusion like something. In that stage, what happened? The population number is increased up to the maximum level which can be tolerable to that particular environment. In this stage, there is no net population growth. That means in generally, the birth ratio is going to equal to the mortality ratio. Therefore, there will be no any net population growth. But in this stage, we consider this is as a dynamic equilibrium. Why this is dynamic? In some cases, there will be, due to higher growth rate, the population can be increased. As well as, in some cases, due to high mortality rates, the population may go down. But altogether, if we are considering the entire conditions, the population number will be more or less showing a stationary number or the stable number. So there will be no any significant difference in the population size. So then we are moving to the human population growth curve. If you are going to consider the human population growth curve, we are only able to see two phases, the slow growth phase and the high growth phase or the exponential phase. As we all know, at the primitive stages, the population size is very small, and the resource extraction ability of the human beings are also very less. But when it's come to the exponential phase, what has happened? There is enormous growth of the healthcare sector, the agricultural sector. Many revolutions has given power and increased the survival ability of the human beings. Because of that reason, there will be high growth rate is shown by the human population because of the high birth rate and the less mortality rate. But still, the human population is enjoying the exponential growth phase because of its developed healthcare sector and many technological, the enhancement of many technological aspects as well. But time to time, the nature gives a red signal. Why? Now the earth is reaching to a level where the existing population of the human beings is intolerable. Because of that reason, time to time, some natural disasters like tsunami, floods, volcanic eruptions, it will try to reduce the human population. Rather than that, some epidemic conditions, SARS, MERS, the existing condition regarding the coronavirus, it will try to reduce the number of human population and to reduce the human population growth rate. But still, thank it to the healthcare sector and many other agricultural sectors and many other sectors, still the human population growth rate is very high. Okay, so for today we are winding our video lesson, and in the next coming video with a new important topic, we will come to meet you all. Okay, thank you.